Today, we're on the coast of the Pacific Ocean near Los Angeles, California, helping conservationists save pinnipeds. Pinnipeds are the group of fin-footed aquatic mammals that include seals, sea lions, fur seals, and walruses. Unfortunately, climate change, overfishing, and habitat loss have led to their decline. And other threats like fishing gear entanglements and ingesting plastic are on the rise. Thankfully, places like the Marine Mammal Care Center and organizations like Defenders of Wildlife are fighting to protect and rescue pinnipeds in trouble. This devoted team has given over 8,000 animals a second chance at survival by providing critical medical treatment. I'm meeting up with Hospital Director Dr. Lauren Palmer and Andy Johnson from Defenders of Wildlife.
So we have these four characters right here. These are California sea lion pups. Why are they here? What happened?
Well, these animals came in as malnourished pups a couple of months ago. One of these animals consumed this plastic bag. Fortunately, it didn't cause an obstruction.
Andy, plastics are a big obstacle to the survival of many animals, including sea lions.
They are. I mean, there's so much plastic in the ocean. And when these animals come across it, some of these animals might be starving. They'll ingest it. When these plastics are out there, they degrade in the ocean. The microplastics get into the food of the animals. So even if they don't ingest a bag, they're ingesting fish that has plastic in it.
This is a completely solvable problem, isn't it?
It's solvable, but we have to reduce our use of plastics. But it's a huge problem that it'll take a long time to fix.
But Andy, plastic trash is just one part of the challenge, isn't it?
Probably the biggest problem is climate change. The warming of the oceans changes where the food that these animals need to survive goes. They have to travel farther to find it, and sometimes they starve, and that's why a lot of these animals are here.
But the good news, these four rambunctious little pups were rescued. They're looking like they're ready to go. It's promising that freedom awaits, but we've got to do a little bit of an assessment.
We need to tag them and weigh them, get them out the door.
Andy and I assist Dr. Palmer herding these California sea lion pups into a squeeze box. This enclosure keeps the sea lions stable and safe without having to anesthetize them. These pups get a quick weight before they're each given a flipper tag.
So with sea otters, we use a lot of different types of tags to identify the animal. What's the purpose of these tags with the sea lions?
Well, these tags provide a visual identification, and if the animal is sighted again at another location, then we can keep track of that. We know how far the animal has gone and when. It gives us an idea how well they do.
These pups are looking healthy. Now it's time for the ultimate payoff. These four pups are going home.
Dr. Palmer, this moment right now, what we're about to do, this is what it's all about, isn't it?
It really is. It's a culmination of all the work we do. It's a culmination of the rescue, the rehabilitation, getting the animal better, and returning them to their natural home.
So, Andy, for you, your whole career has been about the conservation of marine mammals. What's this moment mean for you?
It's really important to provide actual care for these guys and get them back in the wild. They're extremely important to their ecosystem in the wild. They tell us a lot about that system and how healthy it is. You know, we spend a lot of time doing science, doing all sorts of things, but these opportunities don't come along too often where we can help animals out, get them back in the wild. That's a really good story.
It never gets old to see creatures that were on the brink of survival get a second chance.
There ain't no going back there, buddy. Gone.
We're gonna go, there you go. There you go.
Just one quick moment of hesitation, then they're off. Back to the wild ocean where they belong. Remember, conservation takes action. Volunteer in your community. Enjoy your local outdoors and defend animals wherever you can.